Hello everyone, and today I'm going to teach you how to use Irok ND63 Pro software. So first off, you need to get yourself a Chromium-based browser. Example of this is Google Chrome or Microsoft Edge if you don't want to install Chrome or something. So how to access the software? Type hid.irok.cn. It's going to ask first, so just click allow browser connection and click your keyword here and tap connect. Now every time you open this browser from now on, you're going to only see this. Just click on it and bam. If you use this keyboard for the first time, just click start key calibration, and what you do is just type your and try to, yeah, it's a tedious process, but if you really want the best performance as much as possible, yeah, you can just tap it like this. Yeah, tap it slowly until you reach the bottom. Okay, there you go. Once you tap it correctly, your keyboard key should turn into green instead of red. So just do this until you're satisfied or all the keyboards are green. Yeah, so just click key calibration completed, and here's the first thing you're going to see. So I'll teach you its functions one by one. So profiles, well, this is where your profiles is located. Example, you want to make a gaming profile and a typing profile. So let's click new, rename it, and let's put typing. Yeah, just click on any part of the browser, and it's gaming. I don't know why they did not put this with enter button instead of clicking anywhere. That's frustrating, you know, but whatever. So let's say for gaming, second is turn off your RGB, seriously. Basics, well, I don't know if this increases latency, but I just turn it on and yeah, whatever. Actions, this is basically a compressed version of general remapping and the other cheats like SOCD, Rappy Snappy, or any cheats you can think of. So example, let's do a general remapping. So tap the key that you want to modify and click general remapping, and then yeah, you can do anything you want with it. I mean, you can put it as left key, click save. Now let's try to tap a button. Yeah, here it is. Okay, I'm gonna type on a keyboard and it's going to be a left click. Wait. See? There you go. Left key. But if you don't want to do it, just click reset and it will go back to A key. There you go. So if you don't want to use this anymore, click the select key. Example, I want to do maybe SOCD. Wait. Now it's confusing. I think this is Rappy Snappy, and this is SOCD, right? Okay, so A. Yeah, and D. Huh? Okay. Please bind the KME direction to different two keys. What the hell? Huh? Okay. Key tester. Alright, so let's try to press A and D. A and D. Okay. It's SOCD. Alright. Cool. Why it has to be confusing though? But whatever. So let's try to disable them. Click reset. And yeah, back to normal. Let's test it. Okay. That's how you use it, I guess. So let's go to the main event. Editing your actuation. So there are two ways to modify your actuation. So first, by selecting all the keys, just click to all keys. And if you don't want a certain key to have rapid trigger, you can just click. Yeah, click them. Click. Stop. I don't want this. I don't want this. I want this. Shift. Tab. Etc. Escape. Backspace. Enter. Yeah, let's see. I don't want them all to have rapid trigger. Yeah, you can do that. Or you can do them manually. Example, you want your WASD keys to have rapid trigger only, so let's do it. Yeah. And how to modify the actuation and rapid trigger? Well, that's the confusing part. You need to tap this first, quick trigger sensitivity, and now you need to edit both your upstroke and downstroke, or whatever, really. Just set it to whichever you prefer. So mine, I like my rapid trigger to have 0.1 millimeter, so I'm just going to set both to 0.1. there you go, 0.1 and then 0.1. okay, and then I want my actuation to be around 1 millimeter, so let's edit that. There you go. Once I click save, this is important, click save, okay? Or else, click save, and now your WASD keys have 1 millimeter actuation and 0.1 upstroke and downstroke rapid trigger. If you want, you can set a dead zone on it. I think it's 0.19. For, well, I guess you can't really set it. Let's try 0.21. Yeah, you can do that if you really wanted to. And yeah, just click save. Let's test it. It has rapid trigger. I'm not really pressing the key that hard, but it gives me presses, so I guess that works. And that's it. Now you know how to use this software. Thanks for watching.